So you're at your favorite restaurant, you're super excited because the appetizers have just arrived. You grab your spoon, ready to dive into your soup, which is when you notice there's a hair in it. Now you have a few different options here. You could send it back to the kitchen, you could pick out the hair and eat the soup anyway, or maybe just slurp down the soup, hair and all. Now as long as it's a single strand of hair, it probably won't do you much harm. A whole clump would be a lot more dangerous. That could form a giant hairball in your stomach and earn you a trip to the hospital. But in your soup, there's just one single hair. And while it is possible that stowaway bacteria might try to hitch a ride on that hair, leading to an upset stomach or diarrhea, it's pretty unlikely. The hair itself is made up of a densely packed protein called keratin. Humans aren't capable of breaking down keratin. Instead, small amounts of hair will typically pass right through your body, along with everything else you can't digest. So you could probably take your chances on this lonely hair. But if the chef whips up a full plate of freshly cut locks of hair, you might want to seriously reconsider because large amounts of hair will get stuck in your stomach. It happens to cats all the time. Cats also can't digest their hair, or in this case, fur. And whatever doesn't pass through their digestive systems builds up in their stomach as a firm, dense hairball, also known as a trichobezoar. Eventually, most cats are able to vomit up hairballs before they get too bad. Humans also start to develop hairballs if they eat a lot of hair, which sometimes happens to people with trichophagia, a compulsion to eat hair. But instead of being vomited back up, a human's hairball just sits in their stomach, getting in the way of everything else their digestive system is trying to do. In the most extreme cases, a tail of the hairball can reach down into the small intestine, a condition known as Rapunzel syndrome. Major surgery is pretty much the only way to get rid of a problem hairball, where the doctor opens up the digestive tract and pulls out the hairball. So, all things considered, it's probably not worth eating a really hairy bowl of soup. Thanks for asking, and thanks especially to all of our patrons on Patreon who keep these answers coming. If you'd like to submit questions to be answered or get these quick questions a few days before everyone else, go to patreon.com/scishow. And don't forget to go to youtube.com/scishow and subscribe.